During Peter's residency, he made the Beck horse. This video describes the process he used. He began by making an accurate drawing to describe his idea for the proposed work. He sculpted half the horse in plasticine at the correct size. From the plasticine model, he made a silicone mold. He used the silicone mold to cast the horse in wax. He used a lost wax process to produce a plaster of Paris mold from the wax horse. He used the plaster mold to cast the horse in lead crystal glass. Peter began the next stage by preparing 10 sheets of clear glass. By referring to his initial drawing, he drew a section of the three-dimensional form on each glass sheet. Using these drawings as guides, he engraved the plants and the hindquarters of the horse as hollow spaces in the glass.
pretty much. Okay. Nice view.
And added touches of coloured pigment. He carefully aligned all the glass sheets, spreading a special adhesive at each stage. This is where Peter says he wished he had more hands. He set the adhesive with ultraviolet light. Peter trimmed the assembled block and carved into its surfaces. He ground the surfaces that needed to be smoothed and also added some optical effects. The block and the horse aligned perfectly to create the final work, the Beck horse rising out of the water, just as the Norse myth describes.